guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you enjoyed that little montage of our weekend, because technically Wednesday should be vlog day, but I don't know. We did a few things, it was awesome, but there wasn't too much to cover. I thought I would share with you 10 European habits that I don't think too much about until I go back to the States or I'm talking to somebody from the States. Just how different these things are. For those of you that are new, hello, my name is Eileen. I have lived in Europe for almost a decade. Next year will be a decade. How insane is that? I moved to the United Kingdom to London in 2010 and lived there for about 6.5 years. And then we moved to a small village just outside of London. About 1.5 years ago, we moved to Switzerland. So I've been in Europe for a while now. And a lot of these things I'm going to mention that I don't realize that they're exclusively European until I go back home. The first thing on the list, and this is not staged, I promise, but I poured a glass of water before I started filming, but ironically, it's number one. I don't use ice. In America, everything has ice in it. When you go to a restaurant, it's almost like they fill your cup to the top with ice and then you get a little bit of liquid. Here, it's pretty standard, you don't get ice. You'd have to specifically ask for it in most restaurants. And at my house, if I offer somebody water and pour them water, I don't put ice in it, ever. Somebody would have to ask me for it. When I first moved to the UK, I thought it was so strange that people didn't drink ice. I would have a sip and be like, it's not even cold. But now, I prefer it this way for the most part. There is the odd time, usually in summer, that I'm like, oh, I just want like an ice cold, cold, cold glass of water. But for the most part, no ice. Don't do ice. The second thing on my list is I have adapted to life without air conditioning. I know, gasp, shock, horror. I forget that that's such an exclusive thing in the United States until new Americans move over to Zurich and they are struggling through the summer. And I'm right there with them. I struggle too, but the only thing now is I'm used to it and I can be a lot warmer in my house. I mean, when you're warm, you just strip off more. I'm wearing like a tank top and shorts. And then if it's blistering, disgustingly hot, I have fans and that works fine. I think the attitude in Europe is that air conditioning isn't really necessary because it doesn't get hot enough for long enough. But I think in the United States, we are really spoiled for air conditioning because even when it's not really that necessary, you can open your window and get a nice breeze inside. People are pumping the AC. And I even think sometimes it's freezing. I mean, sometimes you walk into a space in the United States, you're like, it's so cold in here. The air conditioning is really king in the US, along with ceiling fans. We don't really do ceiling fans here at all. My son loves going home to North Carolina and seeing grandma and grandpa's ceiling fans because he thinks they're just the wildest thing, this thing that spins around on the ceiling. We don't get them here. We don't have AC. It's very strange for somebody to have that. If they do, it's a unit that they have to like put in their window and install. Just not a thing, and I'm used to that. Number three is, this is very British of me specifically, I am fully in the tea culture. If somebody comes into my house, the first thing out of my mouth is, can I get you coffee or tea? I'm happy to serve tea. It's a very social thing in the UK. You typically would have a cup of tea, maybe first thing in the morning if you're hardcore, and then you'd probably have another cup around 11. It's a thing at work. At about 11 o'clock, somebody in the office is asking around who would like a cup of tea, and making tea for everybody. And then again, probably around 3, you'd have another cup of tea, and then maybe again in the evening. There is a lot of tea to be drunk. I offer tea to everybody, and I am very, very European in that way. I love a good cup of tea. Number four is I have grown used to living in a much smaller space than your standard home in the United States. A lot of the homes that I see on TV, really, on YouTube, some friends' houses, places I go in the US, they're massive, and that is great. It's such a luxury. But in Europe, people tend to live in much smaller spaces. Like, we have a 4-bedroom flat. We have 2 bathrooms. In the United States, if you live in like a 4-bedroom house, I would say there's usually 1, 2, 3, sometimes 4 bathrooms. And I think in Europe, that's just kind of viewed as a little over the top. People can get by with having less space. And I guess in the context of bathrooms, like, is there any point in the day that every single person in the house is gonna need to use the bathroom at the same time? I've gotten used to living in a small space. I actually like it. when we talk about maybe moving back to the United States, I don't know. I mean, I'm gonna eat my words in a few years and I'm like, welcome to our big house. But I just don't think I want anything that big. I don't wanna have to scream at the top of my lungs for somebody in my family to hear me. I like everybody being close together. Close family unit. Number five, in Europe, I have gotten accustomed to recycling as much as possible. I probably annoy people when I go back to the States because everything, I know I annoy my parents, everything that we are finished with, I'm like, can you recycle this? Can you recycle this? Can you recycle this? Because it is just completely standard in Europe and specifically in Switzerland. I mentioned in another video before, trash bags are so, so expensive. You have to buy a certain trash bag at the store for them to come pick it up. And they're so expensive that you're really paying to throw trash away, whereas you're not paying to recycle. Like, you separate all your stuff, you drop it off at certain points, and that's free. Again, I've said in another video, I think we go through like one trash bag a week, which is insane when I think about the United States, where we would go through like one a day, maybe every 2 days. It is definitely more standard to recycle a lot over here, and that is something I've gotten used to and I actually really love about living in Europe. Number six is something I've really gotten on board with, and if I move back to the United States, I will stay on board with, and a lot of friends who have moved over from the United States have said that they're really down with this too when they go back, is taking your shoes off when you come into your house or you go into anybody's house, you take your shoes off. Now, in the United States, just not really as much a thing. In some houses it is, to be fair, and this is just my own personal experience. I know some houses in the US, people take their shoes off. But if you think about it, somebody made a joke once, and I think it makes so much sense. They find America to be such a hilarious culture that they're happy to wear, like, go almost barefoot outside wearing flip-flops and stuff, where it's like germs everywhere and get germs all over their feet, but then they're happy to fully wear shoes inside where there's germs all over their shoes and get germs all over their space inside. In Europe, it is completely standard when you knock on somebody's door, hi, nice to see you, you start to take your shoes off. And the funny thing too is when I'm going over to somebody's house here, I consciously think about what socks I have on because I'm gonna be in my socks when I'm in that person's house. So I check that I don't have any holes, maybe a fun pattern. I'm not gonna wear like a super random color if I have on a color that clashes with it up top. Socks are a very important part of fashion over here because you are just not wearing shoes in someone's house. And I love that. Number seven, and this is more city specific, but there is a complete order to public transport here. It is completely rude and not expected for you to be waiting for a subway or a train, and when the doors open, just barreling onto the train. You just don't do it. It is completely customary and polite, and the way things are done, that when a train arrives or even a bus arrives, public transport's a big thing here. The doors open and you step to the side and you wait for everybody to get off the train first. It works, it's streamlined, the train's not gonna leave without you. You stand there, patiently wait, and then after everybody's off, then you get on. There is no bobbing and weaving through a crowd, clashing, trying to get on and off trains, and I absolutely love that. Another thing, escalator specific, and those like things you get in airports, you stand on one side, and if you're in a rush and you need to walk, there are two separate lanes, the standing side, this is escalators too, and the walking side. So if you're on an escalator and you've got a small child, you know you're gonna stand on the right side. When I go to the United States and we're in an airport and we're on an escalator or one of those standing things, and there is a family or a couple taking up the whole width of the escalator, I go crazy. I'm like, just step to the side. Somebody might be in a hurry. Rather than somebody having to say, excuse me, pardon me, pardon me. There's just a system. There is one line where you stand and one line where you walk. And it works. America, get on board. I love that about Europe and I have fully taken that on. My name's Eileen and I endorse that rule. Number eight, and something I have adopted and I do in the States, and sometimes it catches people off guard, but it's just the European way and I love it, is I kiss everybody that I greet. If it's a friend that I'm like seeing over and over constantly, no, I don't do it. Like if I'm seeing them a couple times a week, but when I see somebody that I haven't seen for a while, I am coming in for the kiss, be ready for it. On the cheek, I'm not gonna make out with you. But if I'm in the UK, you kiss on one side, you go over to the left and they're coming to the left. You kiss one cheek. If I'm in France, two kisses, mwah, mwah. And in Switzerland, tricky, tricky, it's three kisses. Mwah, mwah, mwah. It really gets tricky because if I'm kissing a Swiss person, hello, I'm doing three. If I'm kissing an American person, hello, I'm doing one, maybe two, because I'm like, I'm in Europe and let's do the Europe thing. If I'm kissing a British person, hello, it's usually one. Yeah, that's right. Some British people I do two, and I don't know why that is. I used to have conversations with people in London, like, why is it some people you just do one and some people you just do two? Some people have said that in Britain it can be like a class thing, like the more posh you are, you do two kisses because you're like trying to be so French and bougie and fabulous. Regardless, a European thing that I've picked up, and look out America, I'm coming for you. If I haven't seen you in a while, I'm kissing you, hello, for sure. And goodbye. Let's kiss, let's get close. The ninth thing is when I meet up with somebody for a drink and I'm out and about in Europe, we don't go out to watch TV. In the United States, almost every bar in New York that we used to go into, unless it was like a cute, fancy little restaurant, like divey place, but they had TVs. There was sports on all the time. And a lot of bars that I go into in the United States, I talk like I go bar hopping when I'm home. There's usually a TV playing in a bar, which I always find that a little strange when I go back to America now, because if I'm out having a drink with somebody, I don't want to sit and watch TV with them. But I find that when I go out to meet somebody for a drink, like you can be sitting and you're watching TV. And when I go out with people here, I'm going out to chat and catch up and have really good conversation. I'm not going out to watch sports on TV. And that's like a cultural thing, because I know if there's a game on in the States, some people will go to a bar to watch the game. There aren't a lot of TVs at bars. There aren't any TVs at bars. It's just not a thing here. And the last thing that I've really adapted in Europe is the ability to live a slower lifestyle. Now, I am so fortunate, I don't work full time. So a lot of people are rushing around because they have to, they work full time. I totally get that. But the point I'm making is different than that. I get from people who have moved over here from the United States recently, they always notice that, wow, there isn't like something for the kids to do every single day after school. Like in America, kids start pretty young with like, it's baseball on Monday, it's karate on Tuesday, it's gymnastics on Thursday, it's this. Kids are constantly booked up after school. There's so many extracurricular activities. On the weekends, there's soccer games, there's this and that. And I did some of that growing up as a kid. I get that for sure. But in Europe, it's not really the culture. It's not the done thing to have your kids like tied up in activities every single day. I'm not at that age really yet with Patrick, but I just don't think we'll be the family that's like, you know, chasing him activity to activity to activity. He will definitely have that balance of doing the things he is super, super passionate about, and that's it. Like not throwing him in activities for the sake of being in activities, for sure. Except for swimming. He has to learn how to swim. That's not negotiable. They also don't have homework. Like, kids start having homework usually fourth, fifth, maybe sixth grade. In some cases, they don't have homework at all in elementary school, because the thought is you go to school, you do your learning, you focus, and then when you come home, you relax, rest, and recover with your family, and you are a kid, and you play, and I absolutely love that. It's a much slower, relaxed culture. That's all, guys. Those are a few things that I have picked up from living in Europe. What are some things that you've found if you've ever traveled to Europe that you thought was strange that you don't get in America? Leave that in the comments below. I'm interested to hear from you guys what you think. And also, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider doing so, or I'll see you over on Instagram. I'm at Eileen Vincett. Thanks so much for watching today, guys. I will see you soon. Take care. Bye. Crisscross applesauce, Indian style. I'm feeling Indian style today, sitting with my legs crossed. Can you say Indian style anymore? What makes it Indian style? Do people in India do it? Or is it like a politically insensitive Native American reference? Yeah, it might be, actually, now that I think about it. Anyway, I would do a 10 loud train going by. And have just come from America or are just getting ready to go back. People who have just arrived. Ooh, my camera did a little shimmy shimmy. In some house it is, how do you say that? In some house.